just been casually stalked by a what is it?
Sea lion?
So, we have arrived on the Isle of Skye. We drove up yesterday. When I say we, I drove up yesterday. Smashed it all out, got some food when we got here, and then, where are we, Tom?
The Isle of Skye.
We're on the Isle of Skye. We're at basically a big viewing station thing. And there is seals and seabirds and apparently like whales and stuff down here. But we camped just on the edge of the coast last night. It's a long grass. And the midges were absolutely appalling. We've got head nets on. We got eaten alive this morning, putting our tents down. So I think the moral of the story might be camp higher, hope for wind, except that we're gonna get bitten a lot. I'm gonna go back to the car now. It's about 9 o'clock now. I'm gonna go back to the car and start our adventure, go somewhere else. Don't know, I think we'll maybe a walk today because the weather's supposed to be a bit grim, so possibly walking in it is the best thing we can do. Yeah, good.
Southernmost tip of the Isle of Skye. We have got food, water, all that stuff. It's raining, which means there's no midges, which is nice. And yeah, we're just going to see this lighthouse and hopefully find somewhere down there to camp. It'll be nice. Just cattle everywhere. Thank you. Good evening. I thought I better do an update because I haven't said anything about a day. It is the end of day two, Tom.
Yep.
Day two. We are still in the Sleeve Peninsula, but we've walked down a valley to the coast. A rough day, to be honest. We didn't set off. Well, we walked back to the car this morning, which is about 5 or 6k, and then we drove around a bit, went to the shop, got some food, and then set off again. It was supposed to be like a 3k, 4k walk, and then camp in the woods, and then it was just further than that, really, really boggy. Couldn't camp in the woods at all, so we had to just keep going, kept raining, and we ended up at the coast, which was much further than we wanted to go. And tomorrow we're going to go and make our own path and go up over the top back as opposed to going through the bogs again. And it's supposed to rain all day tomorrow and possibly all day the day after. But we are now on a beach, we are having a fire, tents are all set up, it's a nice evening, the sun's going down in front of us, so couldn't really ask for more. Tom's pretty happy. So we're on our back, way back. It is about 10 a.m. And we are making our own route up. There are no paths. We survived, we're back in the car, we're having a party. So this is camp day four. Is it Wednesday today, Tom? Stumbled upon a pre-built fire pit and a pre-built shelter. So this will be our view for this evening. In an effort to keep track of what the hell we've been doing and what day it is, we're going to do like a little video update every evening to go through what we've done that day. So today is Wednesday, Tom? Today is Wednesday, which is day four. Day four, if you include Sunday, which was driving all day. Night four. We woke up this morning and we were at the beach at the end of the Sleet Peninsula, which we walked through yesterday, which was a rainy day. We walked through a boggy, boggy, horrible marsh. It was supposed to be a quick walk and wasn't a quick walk. And when we got to the end, we ended up camping right at the end instead of in the woods. We ended up camping right on the beach, on the coast, which is actually really good. It looked like there'd been no one there for about a decade. We didn't see a single footprint all day at all. We just saw deer, frogs, that's basically it. We woke up this morning, it was supposed to be pissing down this morning, we woke up this morning and it wasn't raining. We checked on our fire, which had burnt out and had burnt all of it except for the massive log we put on. And then this morning we packed up and we set off about 9:30 this morning. We decided we didn't want to go back through the the valley again because it was crap. So we were going to go over the top. There was no paths. There was no way of navigating except with a map and a compass and just going from point to point. It started raining after about an hour. It was very, very windy. It was very, very rainy. It was all right underfoot, but it was hard going. It was really hard going up and down. We burnt out with about an hour to go, Tom. We just decided we wanted it over with. And then when we got back to the car, we went to the pub, had a drink, had some food, read our books for a bit. And then we came and drove up to the next peninsula around, which is, where are we now, Tom? Just below the Cullens, I guess. And then we just parked up and walked down to, I think this is a forestry commission something, but it's been felled all over there, so they've all gone, all the trees, but there's a little stand here. So we'll come here. This is where we're staying tonight. I've taken the tents back to the car and got the bivy bags, and we found a shelter which is behind me. So that's where we're going to spend tonight, in bivy bags. And in an effort to keep any midges away, got that going. I'm just going to have a lot of brews basically. We've already eaten tonight, when we ate at the pub, so hopefully just drinks tonight and fairly early up tomorrow. And then ferry pools tomorrow, we said, didn't we? Yeah. Ferry pools tomorrow if it's raining, and hopefully there will be a shed load of people there, so maybe do a walk in the day and go to ferry pools in the evening, but we'll see what happens. Right. That was long and very boring, I imagine, but at least we know what's happened. Fire time.
Workout resumed.
So it's Friday and we are basically walking up into a valley between two cullens. But like nothing I've ever seen, just bare rock face, there's nothing growing and so big, so like straight up. We're gonna go and try and walk up one, but there was no routes on the OS map. There's one on the map that I've got on my phone. But when you look on the OS map, it's all buttresses and cliffs, and I just can't understand how you can actually walk up it. And I know it's well known for like alpine climbing. Just not sure if you can, especially from this side, just get up to them. So we decided to walk up the valley and have a look. And apparently the stone from Highlander's up here somewhere. So that'd be cool. It's hard work. this rock here, we think is the scene of the battle from Highlander. Apparently it's around here somewhere, and we reckon this is the best shot. And there should be a beautiful view of the bay behind, and massive, huge mountains above us and around. But yeah, the fog, the clag's just come in, so we can't see anything.
Robin's just been in my porch, James.
It's a monster.